bellissimo, eh.
I'm up here today just to, I'm so thankful, Josh and Zach and Roger Ball and Sam Cook and Richard Hansen, thank you so much for creating such an incredible opportunity for us to really dream again, and it just blesses my life, and thank you to the people that I've touched too. And so Tony wanted me to teach on building a team, and I told him, I said, well, I don't know what I do, I just go out and love on people. So that's what I do mainly. But anyway, when Roger Ball and Zach and Josh and Richard penned, "We Believe in You," I really believe that they saw us standing here today and saw each one of us with an opportunity and a future that we could truly dream again. I remember in school, my teachers would always tell me, quit daydreaming, quit looking out the window, stop dreaming, pay attention, do something, let's do something. So I learned not to dream. So today, I want to encourage you to look out the window, pick up your dreams again, and dream again, because 7K medals can make that happen for you. Yes. So my journey didn't start February 2nd, 2017. My journey started way back when I didn't believe in myself. I didn't know who I was. I didn't know where I was going. I really didn't even know that it belonged anywhere. And so I had some dental issues, and so I went to a dental practice, and the dentist was working on a tooth. And for some reason, he saw something in me that I never saw. And as I was getting my tooth fixed, he asked if I wanted a job. And I was like, sure, I don't have an education. I have no training, no background. And but he said, I want to train you. He said, I want to work with you. So in our process of me, I always called myself a street rat. I love what Zach said, a rat. But I never was in the rat race, but I was a rat. But anyway, I always called myself a street rat because I never had formal education in the dental field or anything like that. But he took the time, he saw a potential in me that I never saw. And so for 28 years, I worked with this dentist to learn how to be a professional dental assistant. I became one of the better assistants in the state of Montana. I traveled around with him and helped him train teams to create the dental assistant so that assistant could make their office more proficient. And so as I was doing that, in my growth, in my self-development, I would get mad at him because he would push me a little farther, push me a little farther. And then pretty soon the era of dental assisting changed, where the dental assistant did just sit there and do the instruments and whatnot. We had to start talking to our patients and making them feel comfortable and incorporate them into the business in what we were building. And so I had to videotape myself, I had to learn how to sell, I had to talk treatment and all this, and I just told him, I'm not gonna do this, I can't do this, I just wanna sit here and suck spit, let me do that. And he said, I can't do that anymore, Colleen. And I said, I'm a professional spit sucker, what else? And so I would get so mad that I would quit and I would just leave. And I said, I can't do it anymore, I just, it's not what I do anymore, I just can't talk to people. So in our turmoil, finally he would call me and I'd come back and I'd try it again, and we got going, and eventually it clicked in me, and I really started loving my job. I love getting up every morning. I love going and working and creating patients that had beautiful smiles, figuring out what they wanted, what they really truly desired. And what was the best part about that was that when they came in, they had no self-esteem. They didn't know who they were. They didn't know what they wanted. But when they walked out with their pretty little smile and they saw something different in themselves, that's what blessed my life. And so I know that my passion with 7K Medals is to do that same thing. Is they may come in like Amanda Ackhurst. You just bless me. And Pastor Sharon. And when I see their lives change and their dreams open back up, I found my purpose and my passion in my life, and so, again, I'm just really grateful for 7K Medals. What Dr. Spencer taught me was invaluable lessons, not only for myself, but for others, And so I've learned to put others first and to really realize that I am a person of significance and that 7 Cape Medals did create a dream for me. And so I believe that if you care about people, that those people will help you create something in you that you never thought you had. And so when I put my team together, we did do the 3-way calls. We worked with Zach's form. And we really try to duplicate what Zach and Josh have on our associate training, but we wanted a platform that would help them talk about their business. And so we found the gun shows and the home shows and the different events like that, the festivals and things like that, that would have vendors. So we would set up a table, and we never go by ourselves. Jay and I never, ever, ever do any event by ourselves. We always invite our team members to come with us. And so when we schedule a gun show or a home show or something like that, we have 2 or 3 or 4 team members with us, and we just teach them how to use the form, how to talk about their business, open up 7 Cape Medals so that they learn. It's basically cold calls, so they just sit there and talk, and I don't let them sit behind the table. They have to come out and around. Nobody gets chairs. They're tired when they're done. But they learn, and by Sunday, I mean, we have Ron and Cheryl Borgielli and Cheryl Lynn and Dylan Cooley from Wyoming, that we did a gun show in Casper, and by the time they figured out from Friday to Sunday, that team signed up 7 people. And so, to me, that was and Cheryl is one of our newest sponsors, and she just said, "Colleen, I'm clearing my schedule, I'm going to Dallas." And so, but it's connecting with the people too. It's not just selling them the business or selling them the membership, right, or giving them the gold and silver. It's really connecting with that person and building a relationship with them so that they become a part of your family. When we say 7 Cape family members, we really believe that. We believe that you've come into our family, and we want to help you just as if you were our baby children and raise you up and bring you into that success and let you see that your dreams can come alive. And so I think if we help each other discover their gifts and their strengths, that really helps solidify our teams too. It's not always just one-on-one, it's a team effort too. So I think everybody has a notebook and a paper or a pen, right? So I have a little exercise for you. So I want you to think about what your strength is and then write that down. Okay, then once you have it written down, I want you to tell the person to your right what your strength is, and then ask them what their strength is, and then while you're at it, get their phone number, and let's start connecting with the people that are in 7 Cape Medals, because we have something great here. We have a strong team here, and I think as we start learning how to connect with each other, we'll be able to do that anywhere we go, whether it be a gun show, an event, or just a one-on-one, or one of these great meetings. We will really create a solid foundation for 7 Cape Medals to really explode this in the next year. So I'm excited about that. So tell somebody to your right or left what your strength is.
Already did it.
I gotta sit up.
I had it doubled. I got his on mine.
What did you do? Nothing. Oh, you got it done. That's
it's because I'm sitting
no
right there.
Get what you get.
You don't have to work with that. It's easier to hold it lower.
Okay, so in that now, just remember that that's what this is about. It's about building connections.
Patience is a wonderful thing.
Okay? And so,
there you go.
I believe that I found this kind of interesting, that what we say is only 7% of what we believe, and the way we say it accounts for 38%. And what others see accounts for 55%. So that's 90% of what our impressions are have nothing to do with what we say. So think about that when you're out there talking to people. When you're talking to them about 7 Cape Medals, what are you really showing them? What are you really telling them? I think that's interesting. So at the gun shows, I love talking to the teams that we have at the gun shows, because they just, from Friday to Sunday, they just turn into these little butterflies, and they're so fun, and watching them talk to people, and it builds their confidence, and it builds their belief system too in 7K medals. I know that they get the 7K medals, it's gold and silver, and we have the best prize and all that stuff. But when you see a person change from it's gold and silver to, oh my gosh, this is me, you really, really, really see such an incredible change in the people. And so that's what I love. And anyway, so develop the leaders within that they possess a conviction, because we can develop ourselves with great mentors, and to become a great leader, we need great mentors. And that, I learned that in the dental field also, that I had a great mentor. My dentist was an amazing teacher, and I'm so thankful for that. But when I joined 7K Metals, I got the privilege to have him, Zach, as my mentor and for 8 weeks. And what he taught me in that 8 weeks was invaluable to what we incorporated into 7K Metals today. So find a good mentor. Find somebody that you want to follow, someone that's successful. I have Diane and Zach that are phenomenal. I mean, how can you not miss when you have that little notebook and she's, you know, calling you and telling you what your notebook looked like? What are you doing? Where are you going? She's monitoring me. Colleen, you're here, here. I'm like, how does she know that? I don't know that. And so it's amazing to find some great mentors in your life and just run with them, because they will bring you and take you everywhere you ever wanted to be. And so I love the book Good to Great. So with that, I just saw the vision of, we have something great here. And I believe that each and every one in this room could really create a historical event with 7K medals in your life. And so I'm thankful for that. I'm thankful for the amazing people that have given me an opportunity to really grow and become somebody that I never thought I would ever be, have a dream that I never thought I could have. And so as I stand here today, I'm just thankful for the opportunity that you've allowed me to come up here and give a talk or a teaching or share my story with 7K medals, because that helps me grow and helps me share what really my passion is for 7K medals. And so with conviction in my heart and love in my heart and passion in my heart, I too can now pin. We believe in you.